Can you hear me? Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon you. We are gathering here today because we want to support the peaceful protesters in Syria who are non-violently standing in the face of a brutal dictatorship that is relying on arms to maintain the status quo and to maintain its grip on power. While the Syrian people are completely committed to non-violence and peace. Are you noticing what is happening in Syria now? The Syrian regime wanted to turn it into Libya. And the Syrian people have committed to non-violence and therefore are managing to keep it like Egypt. And they're succeeding in doing this because of the willingness to give their blood. We stand in humility today for the amazing, the great sacrifices these beautiful people are giving to freedom in Syria. We stand with them because these young people are saying we want to create a better future for our children and grandchildren. In the 60s, a black woman called Rosa Parks Yet it changed the history of the United States, and today there's a black president in the White House. The first martyr in Islam is a black woman. She was killed under torture for non-violently defying the elites of Mecca. The Prophet Muhammad was passing by her, and he never told her, "Hey, you are a woman, go back." He refused to obey the elite of Mecca. And today from Syria we hear the echoes. One, one, the Syrian people are one. Wahid, wahid, wahid. The Sha'b al-Suri, wahid.
Wahid, wahid, wahid. The Sha'b al-Suri, wahid.
This is not just about the Arab world. This is a global revolution in human consciousness. Today, in Douma, the protesters were carrying a large banner which read, "If you shall raise your hand to kill me, I shall not raise my hand to kill you. The two sons of Adam, which is also known in the Bible, confront each other, and one brother says to the other, "I shall kill you," la'aqtulannak, and says, if you shall raise your hand to kill me, I shall not raise my hand to kill you. And in that moment, a new species of humanity rises to a new level of consciousness in which one side refuses self-defense and transcends even the need for survival and moves into a new level of compassion and love and change through peaceful means. And this is what's happening in the world, and it will spread around. Gandhi did it in India, but unfortunately many of us forgot his message, and it happened again in North America with Martin Luther King and Rosa Parks, and it happened again in Eastern Europe, and it happened so many places. So it keeps coming up, and at some point we will finally realize we are all becoming the other brother who says, I shall not raise my hand to kill you, even if you're going to kill me. Inni akhafullah rabbil alameen, for I fear the Lord. And which means that my fear of harming you is greater than my fear of death. Because death is not shameful. We're all going to die. But harming another person or another human being or nature is a choice. And in declining to harm other people, we move into a new way of consciousness. This is what's happening in the Arab world. We are moving to democracy by committing to nonviolence. And the work is yet to come, because after the collapse of these regimes, we have to work to create pluralistic society, secular, civil, in which all of us live together beautifully, peacefully, and to prosper, to dedicate our energies to raising consciousness about the environment and about creativity and about the arts, instead of putting these energies into killing each other and suppressing each other. We need to put all these energies into making this planet a beautiful planet in which we can all live together as brothers and sisters, as the children of God. Thank you so much for coming out today. And there are thousands of Syrians in this city who are still fearful.
Today. wickedness in the air.
Matthew!